follow rules. I just break them and call mine.
Girl, call me on my cell phone. Hate when you leave me alone. I don't like to Instagram. I don't like when you be out.
Repetition. From inside Tropicana Field here in Tampa Bay, Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Pittsburgh Pirates taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about to get underway. Our starter in this one, Zach Eflin.
Really labored his last time out. Four plus innings, wasn't able to qualify for the win, but fortunately got an O decision and didn't take a loss. We'll see if he can get in the W column today.
And now it's going to be Key Brian Hayes.
The third baseman, Key Brian Hayes.
The Y to kick the pitch. Yeah. In for a strike, and this interleague no matchup ball. Is Which underway. Strike? Line to left. A Rosarena makes the grab, and there's one down. Connor Joe, the next Pirate to hit. Number six on the National League batting average leaderboard. First pitch is in the dirt. This to third. And he beats the throw. He's safe. And it looks like they might end up challenging this one. Very close play. And we will take another look as well.
I couldn't tell in live action, that's for sure. And, you know, the umpire is so much closer to the play, and he thought he beat the throw, so we'll see.
Well, they've decided not to challenge it, and so he is safe at first. Brian Reynolds here. In there for strike one. Ground ball right side, could be two. To Franco for one. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. One error in the inning, but nothing more. Now it's the Rays' turn. No score. Back here at the ballpark. And today's starting pitcher, JT Brubaker. What do we need to know here?
Well, no doubt about it. He's going to have to put together some consistently good performances in order to bring that ERA down. Now, he's got good stuff. He's just got to be able to have confidence, trust it, and really go after hitters. Not nibble. Trust that his stuff can have late life and miss barrels of bats.
Randy Arozarena stands in now and watches strike one. That's a strike, and it's nothing in two.
Dangerous spot for that slider right there. Didn't seem to quite finish out front and get that sharp break. Tell you what, he doesn't want to throw that pitch again.
No, that's the ball.
Next one is off the play, and the count one and two. Bounce to the right side. Throw over to Choi. They get the out on a Rosarena.
Batting second, the right fielder, Maxwell.
Here's Manuel Margot. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, don't expect too many more high fastballs. This is a good sinker ball pitcher, and sometimes they can make mistakes trying to pitch up in the zone. Look for him to stay down around the knees to be effective.
And the 0-2. On the ground to the left. Hayes to first. Two up, two down.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
Yeah.
Yandy Diaz in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. And that keeps the inning going.
Everything came together for him. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Lau at the plate. Pitch is in there. That's strike one. Diaz, the runner at first with two gone. Now a screamer into the outfield. That's a base hit. So that's two straight two-out hits. Not sure if too many people have been paying attention to it quite yet, Singy, but that extends his hit streak to 11 now.
Well, I know he knows about it, even if a lot of our viewers don't, and this is when it's clear it's no fluke. 11 games in a row, man, that's when even the hitting coach starts to leave you alone. You're going so good that nobody wants to mess it up.
Here's Wander Franco. There's a strike. Just missed.
One ball, one strike.
First and second, two down. And it is 2-1.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Dives and he can't hang on. He doesn't have a throw and they don't get the out. Harold Ramirez at the dish. That one's in there, 0-1. All loaded up, dangerous hitter at the plate.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Line drive, base hit. Rojal not in time. The run scores. It's 2-0.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. And stepping in for the Rays, Christian Bethencourt. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Corners are occupied with two down. And now it's even up. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
And a base hit knocks in a run.
Comes through with the RBI. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
So two on with two away. Vidal Brujan next to hit for the Rays. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Ripped to short. They take the force out. Inning ends, and that stops the bleeding. They strike for three runs on five hits, no errors, and a couple left on. We head to the second here at Tropicana Field. Rays 3 and the Pirates nothing. New inning getting started at the plate for Pittsburgh. O'Neill Cruz.
O'Neill
Eflin back to work. And takes low for ball one.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Sends it to first.
Out.
One out in the second.
Batting fifth, the left fielder, Jack Sawinski.
Jack Sawinski will hit next. Good power. Not great in the OBP department. First pitch, and he just misses. They say it went.
1-1.
One down, base is empty. In the air, left field, down the line. And he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball.
A defensive swing right there. Some cheese on the inside part of the plate. But the hands are still stinging after that one.
No, that's a ball.
Next pitch misses, and it's 2-2. Checks his swing, appeal to third, and he went around. That's ruled a swing. Two outs, base is empty. So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Andrew McCutchen. Bounced out to short. Franco on to first. And that will end the inning. Nothing doing here for Pittsburgh. They trail in this one 3-0. Bottom of the second. And now it's Jose Siri.
The center fielder.
And the right-hander back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Saying he wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
Boots it. He decides to hold on to it, and they don't get an out on the play.
Pretty much gifted a leadoff base runner right there. And as an offense, this is where you really want to take advantage. Apply some pressure this inning. Make that error hurt.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. Grounded out his first time. That misses. 1-0. Siri gets his lead at first. Nobody out. That one's in there. And a count 1-1.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
On the ground right side, 4-6-3, and they turn the double play.
The right fielder, number 13, Maxwell.
Manuel Margot up to the plate. First offering misses badly for ball one. There's a strike. Pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike. Bounced up the middle. Cruz gets it to first. And that is the inning. Set for the start of the inning. And now the hitter, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi.
Eflin, a 6'6 righty, 28 years old. He joined the team as a free agent. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Choi throws right, bats left, hitting seventh in today's lineup. And they went out and made a trade for him last season. The next pitch misses, and now 2-0. kicks and fires.
Strike.
He swings and fouls one off. The pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The pitch. 3-2 now.
Full count.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The kick, the 3-2. Swings and misses, struck him out.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count. 3-2, he goes off speed, gets the out.
Here's the second baseman, Mark Mathias. He swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1. Mathias measures 6 feet even, 200 pounds, and he was a third-round pick back in 2015. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. He's got it, and there's two away.
Batting nine, the catcher,
Now at the plate, Andy Rodriguez. This is another guy capable of hitting tape measure home runs. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he'll pull in there with a stand-up double.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Challenged him with the fastball right in the heart of the zone, and he was clearly ready to jump all over it.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now batting Key Brian Hayes. He's 0-1. That's in there. That's strike one. There's a strike.
Well, he's gotten ahead with two pitches down in the zone. He has plenty of options right here. He can go up, he can go away, he can add velocity, he can subtract.
Two outs and one in scoring position. On the ground. On the run, sends it over to first. Low throw, and he can't dig it out.
Not every base hit is a liner into the gap, just like not every strikeout's a perfect slider down and away. I mean, right there, he just put the ball in play on the ground and gave it his all to get down to first for the knock.
And now, Connor Joe. Bounce to the left side, and it goes just foul. Joe, in his second season, 30 years old now, and he's been on a fantastic run at the plate, hitting over 450 in his last 10 games. On the ground, right side, base hit, and a run comes in.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Up next for the Pirates, Brian Reynolds. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. On the ground, right side, Ramirez takes it himself, third out. But they pick up one run on the RBI single, and this is now a 3-1 ball game. You're watching Tampa Bay Rays baseball on The Show Florida. As we go to the last of the third, here's the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. The wind of the pitch. That one finds the zone. Strike one. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Got him swinging. Slider got him for strike three.
No need to deviate from the slider right there. The hitter just not making the adjustment. He came at him with the breaking ball, pitch after pitch in that at bat, and evidently there was no answer for it.
Lau batting for the second time, and that's strike one. That's a strike, and a count is 0-2. And here it comes. On the ground, right side, fires over to first. And a couple of quick outs.
The batter, number 5, shortstop, Wander.
Now batting Wander Franco. Reached on an infield single his first time. And that's in there for strike one. And misses inside. And a count 1-2. Ground ball right side. Throw over to Choi. Franco gone on the play. That's the third out. Inning over. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. And the score stays 3-1. Back here at Tropicana Field, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, O'Neill Cruz. The right-hander back to work. On the ground to third. Not in time. An infield knock to start the inning.
Boogie doesn't care how he does it. He just wants to get on base. And when he does, that puts him in a position to do some damage, put some pressure on the defense as well. His wheels are truly a weapon out there.
So digging in, Jack Sawinski. Check swing, no appeal. Ball one.
One ball, no strike.
And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Hit, connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner. When with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
McCutchen in the box now. No balls and a strike. In there at the knees, and it's 0-2.
And that's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation, runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Gets a piece, and it stays 0-2. Rip towards third. Diaz to second. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. On now to the bottom of the fourth. Rays 3 and the Pirates 1. Back now in Tampa Bay, ready to go, bottom four. And now the first baseman, Harold Ramirez. Brubaker back to work. Pitch misses there, and that's ball one. There's a strike. Ground ball up the middle. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. He doesn't have a play, and they catch a break as they get a base runner at first. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Christian Bethencourt. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. In there for strike one. At the belt and fires. In the air, right side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One down.
The batter, number 7, designated hitter,
And now it's Vidal Bruján. He's 0 for 1. In there, and it's 0-1. Ramirez, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. In the air, left field. And there's two away. So two down now, and here is Jose Siri. First pitch, just misses.
One ball, no strike.
Hit hard, that gets through. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. And that knock bumps his hitting streak into double digits, Chris. He's hitting 10 straight.
Yeah, and on a nice trajectory, average going up, OBP, everything he's doing at the plate right now just seems to be working.
Randy Arozarena digs in now. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
The next offering misses. And the count even one and one. Bullpen action for the Pirates. Johan Oviedo, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Here comes a pitch. And that's outside.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Righty delivers. And a rope into center field, base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. One run is in. Another comes in to score. It's 5-1.
Back-to-back base hits. Off the bat, that one registered at 105 miles per hour, man. That is smoking. And these days, you hear it all the time, but the numbers just don't lie. If you can drive a ball like that, more often than not, you're picking up a knock.
So two down, Manuel Margot getting ready to hit. First offering, and it just misses. In the air, center field. He's got it, and that is out number three. Two runs, three hits, no errors, and one left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Rays 5 and the Pirates 1. And welcome back. We go to the top of the fifth at the plate for Pittsburgh. G-Man Choi. The wind of the pitch. That misses the zone, and it's 1-0.
You know, these Pirates just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. Chasing pitches has been a big part of the story. We've seen it quite a bit today. It's been tough for them to make contact at times, and it just doesn't look like they're seeing it very well as a group.
Now this is in the air down the line. Tries to make the play, but it's foul.
And on the mound, you know confidence has to be pretty high with all of the swings and misses. He's had him eaten out of the palm of his hand pretty much all game.
Swing and a ball hammered left field. And that one is out of here. G-Man Choi goes the opposite way. Third home run of the season, and they slice into the lead. It's 5-2.
One got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Now it's the second baseman, Mark Mathias. Next offering is down low. Ball one. Next offering misses. And that's ball two. Eflin maybe a little less aggressive on the mound right now after that home run, Chris.
Yeah, it seems that way. You know, guys, they can come out, feel good, but then all of a sudden get touched up a little bit, and they start trying to throw instead of pitch. They're not trusting their stuff.
And a swing and a miss. One out.
Toughest pitch to hit. Fastball on the outer black. Man, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
And here's the catcher, Andy Rodriguez. One for one with a double and a run scored. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Well, he's been good for the most part. Is it going to take someone going out to the mound to maybe refocus him a bit?
No, partner, every pitcher's a little different. I liken it to you. Sometimes you come in and you're not as focused, and I kind of do what it takes to get you on track, and then you have a great show. Perhaps it's the same with him. Nobody really wants their rhythm broken up, but sometimes they need a little pick-me-up.
Ground ball to the right side, and he can't come up with it, but plenty of time to recover, and that's the second out.
Up next to the Pirates, the third baseman, Key Brian Hayes.
So the Pirates' batting order turns over. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Key Brian Hayes. First pitch, and he just misses. That one drilled left field, base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Multi-hit game for him now, and with the lack of results he's been having lately, I'm sure he's feeling some relief. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Hayes off of first with two away. Slapped foul. And he deals. That's hard hit on the line. Racing makes the catch. That is the inning. Cannonball coming. It's now 5-2. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Johan Oviedo will take over here.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
For Pittsburgh, number 24, Johan Oviedo.
Yandy Diaz now. Singled and scored back in the first. He's one for two.
Yandy Diaz.
And a pitch. And that's in for a strike.
Well, these Rays really impressing me with the quality of their at-bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in. So I'd say mission accomplished.
Hayes to first. One up, one down.
No matter. Number eight. Second baseman, Brandon.
And now it's Brandon Lau. One for two.
No. One ball, no strike.
Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it, makes the catch, and there's two down.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Two outs, base is empty. Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. That one's in there, 0-1.
Not sure if he was expecting for the pitcher to come right at him, but he got a nice cookie there and just watched it the entire way.
And that one is lifted in the air. Reynolds gets under it. He makes the grab, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Rays, and it remains 5-2. Top six at the plate for Pittsburgh. Brian Reynolds.
Fielder, number 10, Brian.
The pitch.
Reynolds.
Reynolds, a former All-Star, 28 years old, and he was a second-round pick back in 2016. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. So a man on base to start the inning.
He was all over that one. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands.
Here's O'Neill Cruz. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
The 0-2. Yeah. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. So up next, Jack Sawinski. Next pitch downstairs, and that is ball one. And another ball.
Struggled a little bit in this one. Couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
The 2-1. Way out front for strike two. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
Foul ball. Two outs. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Margot makes the grab, and that's the inning. So they can't do anything with the leadoff single there. 6-7-8 due in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Rays 5 and the Pirates 2. Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's a big pass. Oviedo back to work. Oviedo, in his second season, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a slurve, and he works in a changeup. Fastball in for a strike, and the count is 0-2. Out there to center. Reynolds gets under it. Makes the grab, one away.
The catcher, number 14.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Christian Bethencourt. One for two. He had an RBI base hit back in the first. And that's in there for strike one.
No ball, one strike.
That to right. McCutchen puts the squeeze on that one. That's out number two.
The batter, number 7. Designated hitter.
Two outs, bases empty. Now it's the DH, Vidal Brujan. In there for strike one. Next offering is fouled back. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Nothing doing for Tampa. They're still out in front 5-2. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound. Ryan Thompson. He's pitching on 2 days rest. So digging in, G-Man Choi. He's already homered in this game. And a pitch. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. And it's fouled away. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Here's the second baseman, Mark Mathias. In there, and it's 0-1.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
The 1-1. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Franco on to first. And two away to start the seventh. Here's the catcher hit, Andy Rodriguez, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. Now a check swing, but he held up. Right side, and that's just foul. And the pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. And a swing and a miss down on strikes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Bucks go down quietly. They trail at 5-2. Back here at Tropicana Field, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Jose Siri. The pitch. Strike one. Swings through that one. On the ground to the left, and foul ball. The wind and the pitch. That one lifted to left. Sawinski squeezes it. One away.
Now batting, left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Randy Arozarena. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
No strike.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it.
This one's into the gap in left center, and that should be extra bases. He's in with a double, and that's his second double of the night.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
So up next, Manuel Margot. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
And what makes him even quicker is the fact that he's so dialed in on the pitch as it's moving through the hitting zone. He can see how that hitter's lined up, what he's trying to do, and where that pitch is going to end up, which gives him that really quick first step. And that's why he makes so many great plays.
And now the 0-1. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Arozarena around third. So Margot is aboard. The run comes in from second. It's 6-2.
Well done. Drives in the run. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
Now the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. 1-for-3. And that's in there for strike one.
One more.
Again with a pitch out. Margot stands at first with one out. Swing and a ball popped up. That one gets down for a hit. The throw in, and he's safe. So So it's first and third with one down.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game, you get a little anxious and you get away from that. But so far, I've seen him stay consistent with his pregame preparation.
Lau, batting with one down, takes a strike. Left-hand batter waits, and ball one. Now that's smacked to right center. Can't get there, base hit. In comes the run from third. It's 7-2.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. So much of good hitting is finding holes in the defense. That's why you're always thinking line drive into the gap. Those kinds of swings really boost your confidence.
Pirates with a new arm on the mound, Chase DeYoung.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Runners on the corners with one gone. Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. That one's in there, 0-1.
0-1.
Runners are at the corners, one away. To the right side. An uncharacteristic mistake from a really good defensive player. Out towards right center field. That's a base hit. Run scores. The throw to third, and he's in safely at third. And a run comes in to score. Not in time. He's safe. Ramirez next to hit for the Rays. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing and thunder in that bat. Pitch misses inside. 1-0. Right through there for a strike. First and third, one down. There's a swing and a miss.
Well, in this situation with a runner on first, less than two outs, some say, hey, get the ground ball double play with two strikes. Some people say get the strikeout. I think you just execute your pitch, make the best pitch you possibly can, and let the result be whatever it's going to be.
On the ground, right side. The flip to the pitcher covering. Now two away as they get a run across. Here's the catcher, Christian Bethencourt. There's a strike. Runner at second, two down. Down the line towards the corner. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double. A run comes in on the play.
He puts a great swing on that pitch and drives home the run, and that was always going to be a double, but the bounce over the wall just took the guesswork out of it right away. It was a nice swing.
So, man aboard. Next is the designated hitter, Vidal Brujan.
Struck out on just three pitches last time.
Ball one, no strikes. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and
makes the play, and it's out number three. But nine batters hit in the inning, five come around to score. Eighth inning coming up. Rays 10 and the Pirates 2. Back here at the ballpark, here's the third baseman, Key Brian Hayes.
Third baseman, number 13.
The pitch.
Key Brian Hayes.
And takes low for ball one. Out to short. Franco whips it to first on the run. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Oh, nice job by the shortstop to field that on the backhand and gather himself, get his feet underneath him. He had a long throw, but he knew he had plenty of time to take that extra step, secure the grip, and finish the throw.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. He's got it, two down.
Now batting, the center fielder, Brian.
So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Brian Reynolds. Hit well, right field, way back, and gone. Brian Reynolds leaves the yard. His fourth home run of the season. It's 10-3.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Two outs, nobody on. Now it's the shortstop, O'Neill Cruz. First offering, misses the mark. Hard hit down the line and left. And it one hops the wall. Takes the turn, he's digging for second. In safely, it's a double and his second hit.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
And here is Jack Sawinski. Right-handed reliever. Lifted in the air, out to left. And that's the inning. One in the inning for the Pirates on this solo homer. And it is now 10-3. Back now in Tampa Bay. And now the center fielder, Jose Siri.
Jose Siri.
The right-hander back to work. That catches the corner. Ball one there.
One ball, one strike.
That one back up the middle, and it gets through.
Another multi-hit game for him. He's been really hot lately. That can be a really tough pitch to handle, a front door.
Now a move being made for a pinch hitter, Josh Lowe. A runner at first for him, nobody out.
Number 15.
Going along. Line drive, caught!
Now batting, the right fielder, Manuel.
Man at first, now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot. And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes. Siri at first, one gone. Maybe a two ball. Five, four, three. It's a double play, and that'll do it for the inning. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Threw eight full, Rays 10, and the Pirates 3.
There is a child, music made me smile. Some people called it rhythm and soul. I could never get enough of this kind of stuff.
So remaining in the game defensively, Josh Lowe. He'll be the new left fielder after entering the game as a pinch hitter.
Number 15.
And now it's Andrew McCutchen. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Here comes the 0-1. Shoots a line drive single into right center. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. Good piece of hitting going the other way with that pitch to beat the shift. You know, not a lot of guys are willing to do that, even with the shift on, because they're looking to pull the ball with authority. But it's a pretty easy hit if you want it.
High fly ball down the left field line. Puts it away for the out.
Now that second baseman, Mark Mathias.
Man at first, Mark Mathias, the next Pirate to hit. In there, and it's 0-1. On the ground to short. One at second. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. So they're down to their final out. Andy Rodriguez, the next Pirate to hit. And that's in there at the knees. Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Mathias coming home. He'll score easily, and they're on the board, but lots of ground to make up.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball, and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow-through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time.
Now here is Key Brian Hayes. And a foul ball. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. And he'll make the catch. Ball game. And the Rays take the series opener here at home.
Well, I'm not sure if he expected to get 9 outs in this one, but he had the gas in the tank to get it done. Kind of a throwback save for this guy today, but helps the team get the win. As you can see, they're pretty happy about it, and they're celebrating his performance in this one.
10-4 is how it ends. Roger Dodger, ground beef control. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shombe. We'll see you soon.
My soul start to grow colder than the North Pole. I try to focus on the hole of where the torch goes. In the tradition of these legendary sports pros. As far as I can see,
the final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Rays, 10 runs, 15 hits, 1 error. They left 5 men on base. For the